will be talking about child rights and child abuse. The basic facts that we will be discussing today will be about child rights and child abuse. The basic facts are that the rights of the children and the basic facts and background is that what are the basic rights of children, what is the child neglect, and what is the definition of child abuse, what are the causes of child abuse or reasons for child abuse, what are the types of child abuse, and how to help the child with child abuse, and how to manage the child with child abuse. Basic facts are, the Convention on the Rights of the Children was held, you see, under the auspices of the WHO, and the basic facts that came out that children's rights are violated throughout the world, every day, right of the life, survival and development, they were all in danger. About 8 million children, they are dying. 8 million children, they are dying every day throughout the world. So the development world, about equal number are disabled and majority have poor quality of life. Next. 1100 children are dying per day in Pakistan, that is about one child per every minute. Next, about 50% of children are not enrolled in the primary education and 50% remain unimmunized in Pakistan, therefore exposed to infections and high mortality. Next, children's lives are violated throughout the world every day, and 15 to 20 million children they are working as slaves at this moment, and an estimated 2 million children worldwide are sexually exploited every year, and 300,000 children around the world are actively participating in more than 20 armed conflicts throughout the world. Next. An estimated 25 million children and adolescents, meet up to 19 years according to the WHO, are currently afflicted from their homes. They make up nearly half of the refugee population worldwide. There are an estimated 100 million children living on the streets today. They are homeless and they can be exploited very easily by people around them. The Convention of the Rights of the Child recognizes each one of the practices as a violation of human rights and obliges each government to work toward eliminating these practices within their own nation and throughout the world. And Pakistan is a signatory to this convention. Next. Only 3 major causes of death occur in newborn babies, and these are birth asphyxia, infections, and complications of low birth weight and premature delivery. And that includes lack of care for mother, poor protective health services in the country and in the hospitals. Next. Only 4 common causes of death in children. Now this is about children older than 1 month. Globally, pneumonia is the commonest cause of death. About 2 million deaths occur per year, and diarrhea kills about 1.5 million children per year. Malaria leads to death of 1 to 2 million children, and in Pakistan, pneumonia and diarrhea, they kill about 1.5 lakh under 5 children per year. Immunization, breastfeeding, safe water drinking, ORS and IMNCR implementation can prevent majority of these deaths. Next, please. State of World and Pakistan Children. Globally, 7.6 million under 5 children they start every year, and 0.65 million per month or 1.6 lakhs per week, 25,000 per day and 16 per day. And in Pakistan, 0.4 million under 5 children, under 5 age, these children die per year, and 1 to 2 children every minute, and this can be avoided. Next, please. What is the Convention on the Rights of the Children? Next, please. The Convention of the Rights of Children is a treaty that lays out the rights of children and the standards to which all governments must aspire in order to promote these rights. Now, the rights that we recognize, they are given in these sections. Next. It has got 54 articles and it protects the rights of the children and young people up to 18 years, some countries up to 25 years of age across the world. Article 141 each outlines the right set of how children and young people should be treated. They have their own rights and they should be really taken care of, and they must be given protection and help to promote their well-being, their livelihood, and at the same time their growth and development. The other 13 are all about how governments and adults should work together to make sure that children and young people can access and enjoy their rights. And these are 141. Next. United Nations Child Rights Convention. This is the United Nations Child Rights Convention. These rights are the things that are important to make sure children and young people are safe, are not discriminated against, and have their best interest protected. They have the things they need to survive and develop. They have the same decisions that affect their lives. They must be consulted. Next. Four main principles of Child Rights Convention. One is non-discrimination, and that article 2. Governments must ensure, these are the responsibilities of the government. Government must ensure that all children and young people enjoy their rights. No one should suffer discrimination of food, education, psychological development, social well-being, opportunities to have job training and getting jobs. Number 2, best interest of the child, article 3. When governments make decisions that affect children and young people, they must think about best interest of the children first. Next. Number 3, the right to life, survival and development. Article 6. This article is related to the right to survive and to development of the child into a normal human being, and so that he can be of use to the country. The views of the child, article 12, they have a right to participate in all matters affecting them, and those views should be given due weight. And then you can make decision about their well-being, about the decisions which affect them. They must be taken, considering the children's opinions. Next. What are your rights? Number 1, name and nationality is the right of every child. Freedom of expression, that must be ensured that they can express their views freely without any fear or fervor. They should have proper education, and that must be provided by the government. They should have a right to leisure, recreation, and cultural activities. Then, additional protection under Child Rights Convention, child labor must be avoided, drug abuse should also be taken out, and sexual exploitation, that must be taken care of, that the children, especially children who live on the streets, they are not exploited by other people who are around them. The sale and trafficking and abduction of children for process for the modification and to sexual exploitation by the adults looking after them or the who are around them, and sale and trafficking and abduction of children for personal purposes by the adults, that must be avoided, and they must be protected against torture and deprivation of liberty. Next. Armed conflicts, children, they form they are used in the armed conflicts. About 20 groups are there in the world, and that it must be ensured that they do not participate in armed conflict, because that will lead to their loss of life or their many deaths. Next. Priorities for priorities in charge rights. They should have a right to life. There should be no abortion. If mother is who gets in pregnancy maybe unwanted, they go for abortions under pressure. There should be no abortion, and no fresh stillbirth should be fresh stillbirth should be the right to survival that can be ensured by growing. Breastfeeding only 25%. Breastfeeding is seen, exclusive breastfeeding is seen only in 25% population, and immunization coverage is only 50% of the children in Pakistan or in the hand in developing countries. The for development, education is essential, and literacy rate in Pakistan is only 35%. 5 million Pakistan children are not going to school. 5 million children, they are not going to school. Next. Non-discrimination, that must be ensured. But here, girls are discriminated against, although the trends are changing. But still, girls in rural areas, they are discriminated. They are not given proper diet. They eat in the end, it's even all. The adults, they have eaten and boys have eaten, and they are marginalized. High fertility rate, low contraceptive prevalence lead to 50% anemia during pregnancy. Best interest of the child, there should be no child labor, no abuse, and there should be proper nutrition for mother also, because if she is well nutrited, she can deliver at the same time. There will be some decrease in premature labor, there decrease in cases of low birth baby, decrease in anemia, decrease in sinus or abortion, and baby, once he is well nutrited, he can really have better immunity. In Pakistan, 170,000 children, they live on the streets. Views of the child must be heard, and they must be given weight. So what they want, we don't enforce our own decisions on the children. Next. You respect the nature, emotional and social support of the child. Next. Access to quality, free, compulsory primary education. Every child should really have a right to have primary education. And in Pakistan, they say that primary education is free, but most of them, they do not leave the schools. And there should be non-discrimination, access to education. There should be no gender gap. Boys and girls, they should have equal chances to study. And right to the education and cultural activities is given to the children about the convention, and that must be ensured. Next. Right to health. Access to quality health services. Here, it is unfortunate that you see in Pakistan less than 1% of the gross developmental budget is reserved for health purposes, and see the most common sufferers are mothers and children, and therefore see, they do not give a proper access to the health, and health in government hospitals is really inadequate, and health care in private hospitals is very expensive, and most of the people they cannot get health facilities for their own children. Rights of children with disabilities must be ensured that children who are disabled, they must also have the access to education, they must have access to the health, they must have the access to the facilities for the mobility, and they should also learn to educate. And right to benefit from social security, that must be ensured, but here they say we are not providing facilities to people and children to have social security. Even the basic needs are not met with, and how can we really benefit provide social security to the population? Right to an adequate standard of living is must be ensured, but the majority of children, more than 70-80%, they live in villages, and their kids do not have the facilities of proper and safe water for drinking. They do not have the proper safe disposal of excreta. So how can these children find as adults they have a standard living? Next. Right to special protection. The protection from all forms of exploitation, economic, sexual, that must be given to the population. 3.6 million Pakistan children are involved in child labor by official data. Unofficial figures may be 3 times higher. Violence against women may be physical, psychological, and sexual. Exploitation by the adults. And female genital amputation, mutilation, and early marriages are also exploitative for the children. Next. Torture and deprivation of liberty for juvenile and in conflict with the law. Hazardous occupation, smoking, substance abuse, and trafficking is also seen in children, especially who are street children, and most of them are sexually exploited. Next. Child abuse. Now Duncan has said, so long as little children are allowed to suffer, there is no true love in this world. Next. Definition of child abuse. The physical or mental injury, sexual abuse or exploitation, negligent treatment of or bad treatment of a child under the age of 18 by a person who is responsible for the child's welfare under circumstances would indicate that the child's health or welfare is not or threatened, and this is done by adults who are looking after them. Next. Type of child abuse. There are many ways in which you can appeal to them. You can have a child neglect, but really from this the largest proportion child is neglected, is not given proper attention. 34% children they suffer from neglect. And sexual abuse is seen in about 30% children, and physical abuse means is the beating, slapping, and is the burns by cigarettes, that is seen in about 28% children, and emotional abuse is seen in about 8% children. You must suspect child abuse. If that is three, you must be suspect child, you will buy nothing then. That history fit what you are seeing. If the mother or the parents are giving one history or the caretakers are giving one history, but you are seeing something different, then you suspect that there may be child abuse. If this a repeat patient or family member of a repeat patient, meet the same person bringing the same child repeatedly, and that if the child is coming for the same complaint repeatedly, that must be made you suspect that there may be child abuse in any form, whether it is a neglect or it is punishment or the sexual abuse, whatever it is. And if there is a history of family violence, they may come. If a father is unemployed, is not earning, maybe his mother is working, and if there is a tussle between father and child, the father and mother, then the child is the one who suffers the most. Next. Physical abuse. Recognize physical injuries, and these injuries could be tears of the skin, human bite among human, may be bitten by the adult. There may be hair loss by simply the hair. He may have frequent fall, he may be thrown onto the ground, he may suffer from injury. There may be head, facial, or oral injury. There may be shaking baby syndrome, that is, you shake the child by holding it just above the elbow joint, he shakes them, and that really results in sometimes fracture of the bones. Head, facial, and oral injuries, and burn by secret, that is another is abuse. Next, bruises. You can see these bruises. Child has bruises, he may have been slapped, and you should see that there are the discoloration, chronic discoloration of different size and different shapes. Next, he has, you see, hematoma of upper arm, that is, there is swelling upper arm, and there are bruises also due to shaking. Next. Now, this is the child has been bitten. These are bite marks. Next. And this is the slapping of the child. You can see the fingers, they have been printed on his left face. Next. Cigarette burns. There. Next. And human baby may have been whipped by an adult for not doing the job that he has been assigned to do, or he has been found slow according to the adult person. Next, child sex abuse. Sex abuse, the exploitation of the child or adolescent for sexual gratification of another person. This is common but underreported because they feel that there may be shame. They may be ashamed to report because it will disgrace the person who has done it. This is common but underreported. Shame and fear. 3,868 cases were reported in 2012, but reporting is rising every year. Actual number is very high, about 10 children per day, more than 3,500. Difficult to examine and diagnose is sexual abuse because in one that they you may not get the proper statement, and they may not admit to the child to the sexual abuse. Next, neglect and emotional abuse. Commonest. Comparing poor nutrition, especially for the girl. The girl may be deprived of the food. I can give you an example. When I was working in Islam, there was a child from, he was living in a madrasa, and he was about 6 or 7 years old child. Now he was brought in with his bloodstained diarrhea or dysentery. The reason was that the child was about 5 or 6 years old, around 10 o'clock at night, he was asked by police to study Quran. The child was very tired, he was feeling sleepy, and he was put in a separate room, locked. He was locked in, and he was not fit. Next morning, he was given food issue because he was not fit, it was contaminated. The child ended up with cerebral palsy. Now, this is what is happening. There are no emotional support, restricting the child's movement, denigration. They ridicule the child that if he is not doing anything, or if he is slow in performing the job that you have to do, is slow, then you ridicule him, you give threats, you discriminate him, and you reject him. If you are not talking to him, that then it will be emotional rejection and emotional neglect, and the child feels that nobody likes him, nobody loves him, and he will feel depressed. Next, thank you.